Well, we knew that at the end of Resistance 2 that we would have to change main characters because Nathan Hale was dead. And when we decided to go to Joseph Capelli as the main character, we thought there's a lot of opportunity for drama there because he was previously in the military. He was a Sentinel. But then he did this thing at the end of Resistance 2, spoiler for people who haven't played it. So he killed Nathan Hale, and in doing that, you know, he became a pariah. He became the guy in the military that nobody liked because he killed the nation's hero. When in reality, he was the hero by saving humanity from what Hale was about to become. So we started with that, you know, that kernel of drama. And then we decided to give him a family and to make him into a much more interesting character, kind of like the old gunslinger who's you know, hung up his guns and, you know, says, I'm not going to fight anymore. But then, of course, this being an action game, you know, he gets drawn back into it. I think it'll be an interesting dynamic. I think, you know, people will need to get to know who Capelli is in order to you know, kind of warm up to him as a character. But because of that, I think it makes it a more unique experience. You know, it isn't your typical, you know, I'm the best guy in the world. I'm gonna save everybody. Hero. He's a guy with problems. He has flaws, and I think that makes him a more interesting character. And as you play throughout the game, you know, you'll see some of the decisions that he makes and the reasons why he's going to New York and doing what he's doing. And I think it'll. In the end, it'll make him a much more relatable human character.
The next thing